now we've saved our best for last as we bring you the top 10 plays of the week.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
In our courtside countdown. All right, we're off and running in Cleveland, where the kid from Dallas made a lasting impression.
Oh, look at the pass from Kidd to Doug Smith, who pounds it.
Jason Kidd, my pick is rookie of the year, and now you see why.
It's a law of nature. Wolves always move better in packs.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my gosh, where did it come from? Why was he there, and where is he going next?
And number 8, the Pacers want to make their move in the paint, but permission was never granted.
Oh, look at the block by Grant.
At number 7, Sir Charles refuses to let Penny cash in on an easy hoop.
Barkley to rejection.
It looks like the Lakers' Nick the Quick is faster than any bullet.
Down the middle, and excellent. Lottie, what a great pass underneath.
Great. If he holds that ball a tenth of a second longer, he gets called for traveling.
At number 5, put a 10 around this act, starring Maxwell the Magnificent.
Oh, what a shot by Vernon Maxwell.
Let's take a look at a little bit of Ringling Brothers here. This was one heck of a circus shot.
Well, no one could accuse the Hawks' Tyrone Corbin of sitting down on a job.
Corbin to Blaylock. What a play.
Ty Corbin reacts, falls down, and knows where Mookie Blaylock should be.
For number 3. Cedric Ceballos is back from injury, and he's up to his old tricks.
Throws it up.
Oh, and it went in.
Goodness.
Oh, an acrobatic shot. All he was trying to do was get fouled.
That's a remarkable shot. The defense is there, and Cedric says, let me create. I am a creator here.
Excuse me. Haven't we seen this scenario before?
Jordan for the win.
Yes! I did it again! He is now back! Holy mackerel!
And for the number 1 play of the week, Stacey Augmon astounds as he stretches our imagination.
Stacey gets a double team and doesn't have a passing angle.
Stacey, as only the plastic man can.
Yes, you can, huh? Only the plastic man can.
He found a way.